Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough! It's Peach time! But first, a little Grotus. Are you sure about this? Speak up, X-naut.
Yes, sir. Quite, sir. I poured all over our research of the thousand-year door, and it appears the sealing power has definitely been weakening, as Beldum said.
Finally, the treasure of legend. The ancient power of darkness will soon be ours. Listen and listen well. Keep giving the Crystal Star search top priority. Of course, that also includes the elimination of Mario. That meddling scum.
Got it, sir.
X-naut away!
Soon I will have the power that has slept for a millennium. So very soon. And when that glorious day dawns, I'll throw the world into the depths of terror. No one can stop me now. All will kneel before the X-naut regiment. And then I, Grotus, will build a new world. A perfect, ideal world. Yes, a world made by me, about me, and for me.
Well, you know, he's a pretty self-centered guy.
La 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 la. Did you call me? What shall I do today?
Oh, they skipped the shower scene. No! No!
Will I be dancing, perhaps? Disguising? Or will I sing a song or something?
I should say they skipped the possibility of a shower scene. I am conflicted.
Huh?
Mm?
What's wrong, Tech? You don't seem yourself.
Which is more important? Carrying out an order or protecting a critical person? I exist for the purpose of a certain person. I wish to exist for the purpose of another. I do not know what to do, really.
What do you mean?
No, never mind. Please forget my musings. I do not know why, but it makes me feel unpleasant if I make you worry.
What? Feel?
Well, in any case, let's have a quiz.
A quiz?
That's right, Princess Peach. Please answer the questions I'm about to ask you. If you can answer 5 questions, you may use the communicator as usual.
What's with you all of a sudden, huh?
Now, the first question. What will happen if you collect 7 crystal stars? Most of the time, these questions, like 2 of the 3 answers are absolutely ridiculous. In that they, if you pick them, it would be illogical to pick them. But for the sake of showing stuff here, I'm gonna pick something that is incorrect, such as your wish is granted or 1,000 coins appear. Incorrect. Please start again from the beginning, Princess Peach. So basically, you'll eventually get through this quiz if you keep failing on the questions, okay? Okay. First question, the correct answer is thousand-year door opens. Correct. Now the second question. What is the goal of Grotus, leader of the X-Nauts?
To get rich? To become a superhero?
Nah, to conquer the world. Correct. Now, the third question. What is the legendary treasure that waits behind the thousand-year door?
Is this?
Princess, please answer. What is the legendary treasure that waits behind the thousand-year door?
100 million coins!
Nah, it's an extremely rare badge. No, actually, it's a 1,000-year-old demon soul. Correct. Now the fourth question. What does Sir Grotus wish to do with this ancient demon soul?
Cherish it always? Hang out with it? Or bring the demon back to life?
Correct. Now, the fifth question. What is required to seal up the demon again? I think a legendary sword is a reference to Zelda. Maybe, just maybe it is. I mean, this is a Nintendo franchise after all. But it's not a magic spell. It's the Crystal Stars. Correct. You have correctly answered all 5 questions. Now, you may use the communicator.
Tech, you... Was it okay for you to tell me such things?
Please input the message you wish to send. If you don't realize what Tech did there, because Tech is forbidden to tell Peach directly what the plans are, Tech decided to create a quiz and had Peach guess the answer based off of ridiculous multiple choice things. So that way Tech didn't technically
tell Peach the answers. Peach, guess them. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. So Tech is a pretty smart computer. That message has been sent. That is all for now. Please go back to the room.
Okay. Thank you. You're still a weird computer, Tech. Where's my Rubik's Cube?
Good night, Princess Peach. Peach, transition screen. You know what that means. The music. There they are.
My lord, I received reports of a great secret in the floating town of Glitzville. Let's ride the cheap blimp there. Come now.
La 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 la.
You there. Two tickets. One great naval king and one sweet young thing.
Gravy. Bowser, the evil king and a deluded old hag? Life's too short.
Oh, sure, you can jump barriers, but I can't. That's not fair.
What did you just say? Hey, come back here, you impotent little cheapskate.
Get it, cheapskate.
Hey, I'm talking to myself. Where'd Lord Bowser go?
How do you lose something that big?
Huh? Hmm? Huh? Hmm?
Oh.
Oh. It's his clown car!
Forget that wimpy blimpy. I'll be riding this, baby. I snuck into Glitzville once before, so I know the way. No problemo. You go easy on your old limbs and take the slow ride on that blimp, Grandma.
And he's gone.
Oh!
Wait, Lord Bowser, please! Now my special daredevil deluxe brown peg cameo on for go to waste!
Just look at his face flying through the sky like that.
Uh-oh! Huh? That doesn't sound good. What's that warning light? Oh, don't tell me!
Malfunction! I hope he's waterproof.
Stage 2-1, ready to roll. Let's start this.
I think I'm gonna kill myself a few times here just to see what Bowser has to say on that transition screen there. Just a few times, I think that'll be fun to do. By the way, the second number on there indicates how many tries you've done. I know I mentioned that in the little text box before, but I thought I would mention it again. See that now it's 2-2. Now once I kill myself again, it's going to be 2-3. Come on, blooper! Blooper!
Yes, kill me! Kill me now!
Watery ears! I wonder how many phrases he's got here. That would, like, oh, can I destroy the coral? Why, yes, I never tried that before. Why did I never try that before? I should try stuff. I should try more stuff than I've ever tried before.
Like killing myself again. For the third time. I'm on fire. No, you're all wet. Let's do it again.
Remember in the original Mario, the number couldn't exceed 4, you know, because there was only 4 levels per world. Now you're gonna see 2-5. I'm hungry. Bowser's always got a quip. Alright. Someone's gotta fish that clown car out of the ocean, by the way. He'll probably end up calling his minions to do that.
Next time.
You're probably tired of me killing myself. So maybe I should just move on for now. You can keep killing yourself more if you're curious to see what else there is to say. Alright, let's see what I can do here. How can you breathe fire underwater? This is... Well, I suppose there are, like, torches that work underwater and stuff like underwater welding and whatnot. Don't fall in the hole. Don't fall in the hole.
Grab the meat! Yes! My hunger has been sated! Ah, more meat!
Wait, don't.
Nothing can stop me now! Say goodbye to the bloopers and the blocks, and I can't get any lower than this. Oh, I'm back to sort of normal. Oh, I'm not super invincible now. My hitbox is apparently smaller than it is before. Just look at his arms flailing around just to swim. These stages are just so ridiculous. Woo! And we're out! Success! And he's stuck on the castle, that poor Goomba that I squished, it's floating down. Oh, he's small again. He's back to rope port.
That was terrible. I gotta get in shape.
What? Bowser? The Koopa King? Elena, someone help!
And they're gone. Uh-oh. She's got her stuff. It's the Rock Hawk headband. Going to Glitzville.
There you are, Lord Bowser. What are you doing here? I've been looking all over. If I may ask, where have you been, your sogginess?
Swarming.
Really? Neat. As for me, Glitzville is fantastic. The fights are so cool. I was overcome. Even at my age, I was shaking what my mama gave me. And then, the hot dogs. Oh my gracious, Yummerly. You have fun too, hmm? Lord Bowser, is that a no?
It was terrible. You hear me? I swallowed a dang blooper. I wanted to have fun. But forget it. It's over. Go get me some solid info on Princess Peach and the Crystal Stars now.
That was awesome. Yes, sirree.
Hey Mayor, how's it going? I can't believe it was a fake Mario all that time. So we were all fooled. I'm so sorry, Mario. After all you've done for our town, do we hurt your feelings? Well, maybe a little. Alright, it's okay to be in touch with your feelings. So then, you've brought a shining ray of light to our dim little town. Twilight Town thanks you.
Hey, Mario, we need to get back to Roleport, right? Let's go.
Please, come back to visit anytime you like. Okie dokie.
So, I could imagine that. How is the town going now that everything is free and cleared up? Maybe he's gonna go vegan or something. That is true.
Big bright sun goes down, big pale moon comes up, I like moonlight, yup.
This place is our home. No matter how dreary it is, it's brighter in memories. Aww. Aww. And also, A-W-W-W, insert more W's here. Who else has something to say around here? This is the distressed guy who wanted to be a piggy, isn't it? You're a real hero, huh? That's great for you. You really shine out in a dark place like this. How depressing. I guess depression, or not just depression, I mean like sadness, is sort of kind of the theme of the town, despite there being humor left and right in this place. Mario, congratulations on finding your crystal star. These kids are my treasures. Nothing can replace them, and nothing ever will. I hope you'll find something that you can feel the same way about someday.
Mommy, I'm hungry. Pork chops.
Ah, they must really wanted to eat those piggies, didn't they?
I had this weird dream.
Yeah, you were on the moon. Hey, if it ever comes true, could you check to see who really lives up there?
Okie dokie, I will. Why would I be on the moon, though? That seems ridiculous.
What? Mario's not Mario, and Mario is a bad guy?
I'm confused. That means, Mario is a bad guy? Are you oinking me?
Let's see how the shop is doing now that pervy French guy is out of here. I collect the goods and she sells them. Simple. So that's why he was out, basically. A good shop, like a good marriage, is dependent on teamwork, my friend. So show your support and buy something.
Greetings, welcome.
Nothing new, okie dokie.
Bloop, bloop, bloop.
Wait, do I have a spite pouch? I wonder if I should pick one of those suckers up while I'm here. I don't have one. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go grab one. I need one for a future quest, and I just like to pick one up now.
Bloop. Yay! Woohoo!
Or at least a future quest that I'll need a spite pouch for if I want to do it earlier. Gotta go in the chimney. Oh, that's sad.
Bloop.
What do you have to say about this town? Hey, how are you, Mario? Nice weather, isn't it?
Yep.
Well, kind of. You can't tell, you say? Well, take my word for it. It's nice today. Did you see a suspicious-looking shadow pass through here recently?
What?
It was you? Come on, I'm not gonna believe that baloney.
What?
It really was? Care to explain how, then? Sounds very suspicious. I wonder. Just for the fun of it. Nope. Yeah, I just wanted to see if he had something to say in secret. Yes, I'm a novelist. It's, nope. Wait, what was that second thing? Being a tortured... Yes, I'm a novelist. Not all that easy on the eyes, but I write by moonlight. Being a tortured novelist writing through the night is not an unusual thing for me. Hmm. That's the guy that questioned what kind of books that I like to see. Anyway, I still have yet to encounter a really real amazing daisy. You know, like, I've seen the regular kind of crazy daisies, but I have not yet seen a crazy daisy around here, and I would like to see a crazy daisy. You know, I've got to get its tattle. I'd like to show you a strategy on how to defeat it this early in the game without a power move you get later on. So I'm going to go back into the forest here and check around the enemies until I get to a Maisie Daisy, I suppose, but this could take a couple of tries. Basically, you want to just attack the regular crazy daisies and see if there's any amazing daisies around this area. Like, see, this battle doesn't have any whatsoever. It's entirely luck-based, and by luck-based, I mean you might have a bad string of luck if you actually encounter an amazing daisy. Let's just put it that way. They are quite the powerful little critter. Oh, boy. You know what? Why am I even battling these? I mean, I'd really like to save my HP for said amazing daisy battle, so I'm just gonna run from the battle if you don't mind. Thank you very much. Yep. Oh, coin's stuck. Oh, whatever. You there! Bloop. Is there an amazing daisy in here? Is there? Nope. Still getting really bad luck. I'm out of here! Oh, hey, as long as I'm going back to town to reset the positions of the daisies, because none of them, I should say reset the daisies, because none of them had an amazing daisy in them, I'll demonstrate the ice smash. It has the power to freeze stuff, which can be rather handy in that, you know, you can disable it and attack it however you please and whatnot, or even just leave it there until it decides to unfreeze itself, and then, you know, it'll skip its turns so that you kind of conserve stuff and whatnot. Anyway, I'm gonna keep looking for that amazing daisy, I suppose. Oh, from one of my battle attempts, I managed to get a point swap here. I never showed that off, but that's what it does at the bottom of the screen there. And what should I chuck out for? I'm pretty sure you know how these two work, so I guess I'll drop a... Oh, you've seen how this worked before, so I don't need this. Okay. You know what I'm gonna do? Since I'm back here to reset stuff, I'm going to stay at the inn and get myself a Peachy Peach, just to show you where it appears. I got some stats to recover and whatnot anyway, so yeah. And
Well, yes, I did. Have a nice twilight. That's a peachy peach. Okay, I'm gonna go put some stuff in storage and whatnot. Oh, and yes, like all the other grabbable items like that, you can get an unlimited amount of ingredients, you know, grabbable ingredient items.
There it is! The incredible Amazing Daisy! Look at it! Look at it!
That's an Amazing Daisy! This mystical Daisy is like the rarest thing ever! Max HP is 20, attack is 20, and defense is 1!
Yeah! This thing can peel the pavement right off the roads! It has the highest attack power of anything in the game, and it can even put you to sleep like other crazy daisies can.
Since it has such a high HP and runs away really quickly, it's almost impossible to beat. Plus, its lullaby has massive attack power, so if we're low on HP, we need to scram. You gotta think hard about whether to fight or bolt.
Look at it. Look at it. That face. That face right there is the face of death. Oh yes.
But I have a strategy to defeat it, of which I'm going to run away first, because it resets the battle turns, per se. And now what I'm going to do here is get someone... I'll pick Vivian just because she can dodge attacks. That might be handy just in case. So okay, I'm going to do that, and now I'm going to go back into the battle. Because when I do that, just watch this, see that the enemies are the same as they were before. Just as long as you don't leave the area and come back, they'll be the same enemies until you defeat it. Alright, here's the strategy on how to defeat the Amazing Daisies at this point in the game before you get a really powerful attack. You want to use this move, which I haven't really shown before here. It's called Clock Out. It immobilizes all enemies for a short period of time, but it's not a guaranteed thing. So, as you can tell, it selects everything. Well, that's because it's possible that everything... I mean, well, it's possible that you could be hit by this as well. So anyway, just press the button that's above the enemy's heads that you want it to explode over. And when it swaps, just switch buttons. Oh, poopers! It had no effect on him whatsoever. Alright, so... run! And we're gonna try it again. Yeah, it's not a guaranteed thing, but you have the best shot defeating an Amazing Daisy using Clock Out or some other disabling sort of dealio. So here we go. Again, Clock Out. Just keep tapping that button when you see it above the enemy's heads. A button. X. Explode. Hold it there. Yes. Well, kind of. What I could do is try that again, maybe. But chances are it's gonna flee if I try it again. But let's just see what happens. Oh, that's really easy. Oh god, I'm so happy I used Veil! But at least it didn't run though. Oh my god, no! No! That's just no! Oh, it ran now. I guess I got a little bit lucky there. as you can tell there, they are a very dangerous enemy. So it's entirely up to you if you dare try and defeat an Amazing Daisy at this point in the game. As you see, it's not the smartest thing that you can do, which is why I always recommend, or should say, recommend running from them most of the time. I actually saved my game before I did this attempt, you know, using the save block and whatnot, just in case something didn't go quite right. Well, anyway, the Amazing Daisy is gone. But anyway, you know the strategy now. Just disable the Amazing Daisy and then use your most powerful attacks on it before it recovers from its disabled state. And that's pretty much it. Alright, let's go back over to the Thousand Year Door now. Poor Vivian. I'm sorry you had to take that attack. My plan, it failed. But that's only because it's partially luck-based. Oh.
So sorry. I really wish I could defeat the Amazing Daisy, though, because they give a ton of experience points. As a matter of fact, they become... Like, when you get to a high enough level, they become pretty much the only viable option to level up your character, because everything else in the game just takes... I mean, just gives you too little experience points.
Oh my goodness, Mario. Would that be an email from Princess Peach?
How do you know that? How do you know that? How?
My dear Mario... I finally learned what the legendary treasure is. It is the spirit of a demon. The X-naut's plan to revive this thousand-year-old monster and use its power to take over the world. They're collecting the crystal stars so they can open the thousand-year door. They'll find this demon's spirit, but the only thing that can keep it locked away is the crystal stars themselves. You must not let them get the crystal stars. Please, Mario, you must put a stop to their horrible plans. Princess Toadstool. Beach. An ancient... Demon spirit?
Yeah, that doesn't sound too good. Anyway, a speedy way to get to the Thousand Year Door from this side, besides, you know, I mean, I've already showed you this route before, but there's an even speedier way to go through this place. You just gotta slip through the bars like that, go through the door, and oops, not there. For some reason, I thought that was the correct path. Path by instinct. And go on the pipe. Maybe I should have slipped in the bars for further up the path on the upper parts, and there is this place. Yes. Oh yes, that place could very well be the death of me. But here we are at the Thousand Year Door with our new star.
Woo!
The spellbinding circle! Oh wait, what? It doesn't bind me? What am I talking about? Oh, poor Vivian. I'll get you to the inn soon enough. We'll have a nice nap. Everything will be good to go again. Ah yes, Chapter 5 is coming, which is my personal favorite chapter in the game. An island with a blue star. Ooh. Such a cool effect. The location of a crystal star has been recorded on your magical map.
Yay! You better hurry, don't you think? We should go up to the professor's office.
I guess maybe they were sharing stories, which is why they know about... I mean, which is why she knows about this.
We have to let him know about the princess's email.
Oh, yes, indeed. And safely teleported up to Frankly's. What? He always seems to have some reaction. That was written in Princess Peach's email? The legendary treasure is actually the spirit of an ancient demon? And those fiends want to use the power of the crystal star to resurrect it? How bone-chilling. Sadly, it does seem to be consistent with what I've uncovered.
What have you found out, Professor?
This is rather long, so you'd best listen well. Oh no, they're gonna fall asleep. Are all of you ready? And you there, in front of the TV, you listen up too. Oh no, fourth wall break! Don't do that! It's risky for the universe.
Maybe I'm missing something. Are you talking to no one?
Oh, okay, never mind. Oh, you never you mind. Don't you worry about such trivial details. Just listen. A great cataclysm that I read about in that book may well refer to this demon. It says that a monster destroyed a large town that once stood in this very area. It also says that the crystal stars created were actually created by this monster, and that this thing has used the power of the crystal stars to try and conquer the world. According to this book, the demon was defeated in the end by four heroes, but only the beast's physical form was destroyed. Its spirit could not be eradicated. So the heroes used the crystal stars, which they had stolen from the demon. And they cast the evil beast into the depths of a vast maze and sealed the exit. From this, I gather that the crystal stars cannot distinguish good from evil. So if they're all united, they could either seal away or resurrect the demon. It seems that who wields the crystal stars determines if they're used for evil or good.
I guess we ought to consider not collecting the crystal stars then. It would be awful if you found them all, only to have them stolen for evil purposes. Does anyone think it might just be better to destroy them once and for all?
That was my first thought, too. But further research suggests we can't do that. There's a slight possibility that the Thousand-Year Door is weakening. It seems the crystal stars hold the power to seal the beast for 1,000 years. So once 1,000 years pass, the power to keep the door sealed shut will fail. And unfortunately, this year may be the 1,000th year. Bad luck, huh? The fact that those goons want the stars now may be coincidence, but maybe not. In other words, we must be ready for the demon's return, even if the X-nauts fail.
Oh, I guess we'd better find the rest of the crystal stars then, huh? Where do we start?
According to the map, it appears to be somewhere on Keelhaul Key.
Keelhaul Key?
I'm not too familiar with the place, but I've heard countless unsavory rumors. You know, the usual stuff. Vengeful spirits full of hatred, evil curses, things like that. I'm sure the sea salt's down by the harbor no more. You should head there first. It'd be best to ask around at the harbor about Keelhaul Key. Okie dokie. But first, as long as we're in the area, power up time! Let's power up Vivian. Maybe this will recover her HP. Yay! I'm way ahead of the Shine Sprite curve here.
Shazubi! Magical spell is E-E-Poo!
Wait, what?
Yay!
Happy days!
Yay!
Then you may go. And notice, yep, she's all recovered. Very nice. I should actually go stay at the inn anyway. Because of Amazy Daisy Hades. So yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. Right now. Uh-oh. I'll chat with him later. That'll be another lengthy story. Yes, please. Alright, much better. It's amazing what a nap can do, huh? Yes, indeed, Lee, I did. Alright, let's go to the harbor in the next part. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you then. God